Hey everyone, and welcome back to Jessi's Comedy Teacup Channel. Right now we are on our way home, and you know, just wanted to give a little sneak peek to my friend of the live streams, how it works and all that jazz. And yeah, and they really like the song, so it doesn't matter. So I'm just going to sing this song. So I'm going to sing this song. Is called Doesn't Matter What Hole, or also known as What You Get Yourself Into. Okay.
It just doesn't matter what hole you get yourself into. It just doesn't matter what hole you get yourself into. You can put it in my mouth, or you can boogie down on south. You can put it in my ass, we'll have to smoke a lot of grass, cause I know it will hurt. So let's prevent the pain first. It just doesn't matter what hole you get yourself into.
Who is this banshee with a interesting song choice? This is Jessi, a 28-year-old from New York who has made a name for herself in every community she joins. But I'm sure you're thinking, squeak, isn't that a good thing? Not when you're Jessi. When you're Jessi, the Midas touch flows through you, a Midas touch of shit. Every time she joins a community, she floods its spaces with posts of herself. Mean-spiritedness. And posts of her butthole. Jessi is a sex pest, and will harass any man she sets her sights on.
Hi everyone, and this is another rant. Wes sent me a vibrator, and I've never been able to squirt before that. I actually thought it was gross, like pee. But I squirt, and it comes out clear. So being in contact with him was a good thing.
Hey everyone, it's Jessi here. Do you hear that vibration? No, it's not what you think it is. My back is pretty sore. But I'm using the vibrator Wes Most bought for me on my back, and it feels amazing.
Not only that, she was arrested for domestic violence in 2018. Before she can make excuses, here's her admitting to it.
So, I do want to say something, because before it causes me legal problems, I'm going to say that, so I beat up Ed. I'm an abuser, and I'm getting help for that. I apologize for lying. It's not okay to ever lie about rape and everything.
She's a racist.
My name is Ching Chong Charlie, and I know karate. I'll punch you in the body, then say, oops, I said I'm sorry. I'm Ching Chong Charlie. Ching Chong. I'm Ching Chong Charlie. Ching Chong. Ching Chong Charlie.
A transphobe.
On to the panel, mm-hmm. And she, you know, was very, very aggravated, and you know, throwing out all these things and everything. And
hey, Jessi, can we not misgender though? Just because this is a we're going to be editing this segment down, and
but everyone's been misgendering me. I go by they them.
Since when? I didn't, who knew that?
It's been on my channel forever. But okay, she. Is very disrespectful to the community and other members. She
I myself am non-binary and have been out for several years. I would never purposely misgender someone out of spite or as a reaction. Most non-binary people I know wouldn't do it either. If she is non-binary, fine. But she has a pattern of claiming non-binary as a reactionary response. Anyways, Jessi is also ableist. And an overall just shitty human being.
I'm exposing evil McNuggets, cause she likes child porn like Lorne.
If I met Lorne, I would want him to know that I understand what it's like for people to be obsessed with you, to make fake accounts, tricking you, and treating you like you're a terrible fucking person. We are humans and we make mistakes, and I want to be there for him. Hello, I just wanted to apologize to Kim S. Months ago, actually, it was a year ago, I made a picture of a viral meme, but I drew it out myself with stick figures and it just looked horrible, of a man, a viral picture of a man dying in the hospital. And he says, wait, I thought you can't get COVID fully vaccinated. I added that he died. I posted the picture well before her husband even passed away. And unfortunately, I was never his doctor. Didn't even know Kim S was married. Never followed her on social media. So I would not know that A, she was married too. She was married to someone who was dying of COVID, fully vaccinated. The picture was also proven to be posted before she made a post on Instagram. It was like hugged your loved ones kind of thing. And you know, I'm sorry that she lost her husband. And I just want to say that I'm sorry that I was never his doctor and did not know that she was married. So I didn't even know that when she had a husband and two, that he was fully vaccinated, dying of COVID, which was never even posted anywhere on the internet. She probably told people in DMs and private conversations, but I just want to apologize for basically not making a picture about her husband, and she made that up for drama, and it did them well. Easy and Julie and Christ made it all up, and now everyone is seeing the drama unfold and how they admitted to making drama for attention, and these are just the facts. I actually do not understand how people even thought that the picture was about him. I didn't know Kim S was married. Two, I'm not his doctor. I never saw a post yet of Kim S saying that her husband had COVID and one that he was fully vaccinated. And that was the meme picture. Someone, and it was a viral meme too, but I added the beep code blue at the end. So, you know, I just wanted to apologize formally because I feel bad that, you know, I was never his doctor. So I did not know that he had COVID, and I'm extra sorry that I didn't know that she was married. And I'm extra sorry for posting that picture before he even passed away. All right, have a good one.
But Mother Oyster winked her eye and shook her heavy head. She knew too well this was no time to leave her oyster bed.
Jessi is a fan of doxing people as well.
Can we talk about how horrible this makeup is? I mean, does she use a finger to put on eyeshadow? And what is up with that wing? It looks like she has green gunk infection under her eyes. And she puffs out her lips like she's a Kardashian. Chubby cheekbones too. This is Victoria.
Jessi, why are you calling it 5 a.m.?
That was by accident because I wanted to send you the message about like the stuff going on, but I literally hit the end call button as soon as I could.
All right, like, so I see your message and I see that you want to talk to me about stuff, but I need.
Yeah, I don't really have time right now, but
hold on, Jessi. I needed to address doxing me and making claims in Discord that I'm having sex with Nuggies.
No, you did last summer.
I'd never even talked to Nuggies until July 1st of this year.
Okay. Well, now, the other thing I would like to discuss is my name.
That was fucking wrong, and, I don't know why I thought that you would be okay with it because of all this stuff going on and you supporting me and everything. I was wrong. That was fucking stupid. Don't take edibles and stream about serious shit.
Okay, don't blame it on edibles, dude. That's fucking ridiculous. Do not blame it on edibles.
I'm saying that I wasn't thinking.
Well, now you're making excuses. You made a conscious decision.
All right, whatever.
Decision.
I'm sorry for that. That's all. And
Listen to me. You made a conscious decision as an adult online during a live where you knew people who were upset with you were going to be. I was there to listen.
I thought you'd be okay with it, and I was wrong. So.
Why would I? No, okay, so now you're flip-flopping. Now you're saying two separate
things. No, I've been saying this all along, that I thought that you'd be okay with it because you're participating in everything that's going on.
This video barely scratches the surface of what Jessi has done. The evidence highlighted here was mostly personal experience of interacting with Jessi, and with a bit of research on my end. People like Green Frog archive her channel, and have been documenting her longer than I have, and I'll link Green Frog's channel below. The purpose of this video was also an introduction to those who don't know who Jessi is, and how she can be a dangerous person to deal with. I know this seems like silly internet stuff, but she was violent in the past and I truly believe she has the capacity to be violent again. At the very least, if you talk to her, she will use anything you say against you. I'm sure she won't watch this video, but if she does, she'll probably tell me to touch grass.
It's a little late right now, but